Leave. I don't belong here.
It's fun because we're together.
No, it's not. What's with that solid gold dancer with his ass in the air?
The dazzle dancer?
Yeah, why don't you guys get married?
I don't even know if he's gay.
He's got, like, frosted hair.
George Michael has frosted hair and he's, like, totally straight.
Adam, you're 21. You're, like, almost 30. You need to be more aggressive.
What do I say?
Just be yourself.
What's that?
Tell him you liked his dancing.
Oh my God, yeah, that FIT bag and training was there, and of course Keith was there.
The story, she tells it so much better than you.
Oh, yeah,
I'm standing there talking to Keith Haring, and this guy starts comparing him to Warhol.
What?
So embarrassing. He hates those comparisons, you know. Well, I guess Bela Lugosi ain't dead after all.
He is dead. People like you killed him.
Oh, chill out.
How did it go?
Oh, God, I'm such a loser.
You are not. Would I be friends with a loser?
Hey. Sorry about my friend Carrie.
I'm Maura Bid, and this is Rex Havoc.
Cool look, Rex. Yeah, my last boyfriend was a goth. Are all of you as wild and nasty as he was?
The night decrees its own appreciations for some mortals treading the river Styx.
So, you don't like to dance?
Not to this music.
Yeah, well, it is danceteria.
Yeah, more like dance aquaria.
What is that like? Is that like a rib?
Yeah, you want one?
Nah, I don't have much of an appetite if you catch my drift. Hey, y'all want a bump?
The bump? We're goths. We don't dance. We're dead.
A bump of coke. Drugs.
So sorry.
It's all right. At least it's not the same one as last time.
Hey, Rex.
Oh, my God. He totally looks like the guy from the Aha video.
We can take on me anytime. Do you think he still has some cocaine?
Oh, my God. You're, like, totally addicted after, like, one bump.
No, I'm not. It was fun. It wasn't like I thought it would be.
Well, it gave me the total Hershey squirts. I hear they cut it with baby laxatives.
Well, you said you wanted to lose some weight. Hi.
Hey. You okay?
Yeah, just my wrist.
Where do you live?
Brooklyn.
Hey, me too. Sun's coming up. You want to watch it from the Brooklyn Bridge?
Well, I can't just leave my friend, Rhonda.
Good night. Good luck.
Stop it.
So?
Okay.
All right. Yeah, I go to AMDA. You know that theater school uptown? Mm-hmm. They're doing The Sound of Music. I'm up for the part of the captain. Perhaps I had a wicked childhood.
Wow.
Perhaps I had a miserable youth. Someday I'm gonna dance on Broadway. Watch this.
Well, don't give up. You've obviously got a huge talent. Oh my God, just kidding.
I feel like I've known you my whole life.
Really? It's not just the drugs?
Oh, no. This is way bigger than drugs.
Oh, my God, I know.
You got it?
Yeah.
Shit.
When I saw you dancing up there, I knew you were the one.
I knew I was the one, too.
Where have you been my whole life?
I've been looking for you.
Here I am.
This is so fucking...
I love you.
I love you too.
What's your name again?
Watch this.
Wow. Oh, good. More cocaine. You have such an awesome body. Do you like exercise and stuff?
Yeah, I think I'm the only gay guy in the whole world that works.
Hey, what's that muscle called? On your arm.
Huh? There? Tricep, huh?
What about those? Those ones?
Pecs. Yeah?
Like that. Lats. Abs. Quads. Glutes.
Oh my God, I'm like the luckiest guy in the whole world right now. You are so effing hot.
Biceps.
No, I just came up for some fresh air. But if you can't beat him, join him, right? Can I have a hit of that?
Isn't this retro music awesome? It reminds me of slumber parties in grade school. Wow. Somebody needs a drink?
No, I'm straight. Sober.
Really? Wow. I'd hate to be sober. That sucks ass. I don't see why sober people still get to smoke. Nicotine is such a drug.
Yeah, but nicotine doesn't make me wander through gay bars pinching my nipples and moaning, pick me to hot guys.
Wow. Sounds like you did a lot of coke, or crystal, or crack. And now you're in AA. But you don't go to crack meetings, because they're too hardcore. And you're just a nice Jewish boy at heart who can only let loose when he's fucked up. You have a lot of guilt, which is why you need chemicals to squelch your conscience.
You realize you just said all that out loud, right?
Oh, I'm studying acting. So I pick up on people's personalities, you know? Mm-hmm. Guys think they're so mysterious, but most are just really transparent.
Well, I appreciate the completely superficial deconstruction of my character, but I think I'm a little more complex than you think.
Hi, everybody. My name is Mary. And I used to be a bipolar crack addict, but now I'm just bipolar. Yay! Welcome to the Midnight Whip That Crack Fellowship. This is a crack meeting. Tonight's topic is crack.
Birthday.
Happy birthday.
hello?
Hey, honey.
Just calling to wish you know who a happy birthday.
Well, I put him on the phone, but he's in a cake hole. I should be reported to the Humane Society.
Oh, please. I've eaten more than that in one sitting.
Remember my sister's wedding? She's still mad she didn't get a piece.
Right.
And besides, one of the many advantages of being a dog is that you get to eat like a pig.
Hey, fatso.
Ready to go on?
Speaking of pigs, Lou just propositioned me again.
Hey, everybody, you having a good time? Let me hear you say, yeah!
All right.
Well, I'm hanging by a thread here. The audiences have been really tough, and I'm sweating like Whitney Houston going through customs.
Well, you know, maybe you might want to, you know, come up with some new material, you know, since you lost the weight.
What are you talking about?
Help me, Rhonda, yeah. Get her out of my pants. Thank you.
Oh, shit, he's singing this song.
Ladies and gentlemen, Rhonda Gurnon and her fabulous fun bags. Woo!
I know what you're thinking. Doesn't she have a pretty face? And what a personality. If only I didn't get my dresses made by Omar the tent maker. I'm so fat, I eat with a forklift. I'm so fat, when I back up, my ass beeps.
Fashioned from actual ceramic chips recovered at ground zero, to your other 9/11 collectibles. Featuring an American bald eagle, look at her there, in all her majestic glory, with a gorgeous single cubic zirconia tear running down her proud face. Look at that. Now, see, do you see how the birds
Somebody!
Allowed here. Hospital policy.
What do you mean, hospital policy?
You're gonna have to keep your voice down, sir. Now, there is a very good animal hospital over on First Avenue.
But I am not on First Avenue. I'm on 10th Avenue, and there are doctors here, medical equipment, and he has a heart and a brain and lungs just like a normal person.
Sir, please come with me.
There was an accident. I stabbed him. I stabbed him accidentally.
Hello.
Sir, the hospital doesn't admit animals. We have told you.
This is not an animal. This is my child. I'm a single gay man in New York. Don't you understand?
Rob, it's okay. It's okay. Sir, bring the dog on back, okay?
Thank you. At least there is still one caring person left in the medical establishment.
Sir. I think it's National Freak Day. She's got a lady yelling at her vagina out there.
Actors are back. Her dog has a bruised rib, which was,
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Oh, sorry. X-rays. Yeah, your dog has a bruised rib, which the knife must have grazed while it entered. See, there's a little clouding in the abdomen region, which we'd expect in a puncture wound.
Is he bleeding internally?
Yeah, a little, but, you know, nothing life-threatening.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you so much. I can't thank you enough for helping us.
Yeah. It's quite all right. You want to go see him now?
Yeah.
All right. Just right this way.
Hi. Oh, yay.
You know, I have to say that his bat protected him from the knife. Although in the long run, you know, you might want to put him on a diet.
Oh, yeah. I don't know why he's so fat. I'm Adam, by the way.
Oh, I'm Dr. Hicks. Stephen.
Are you a veterinarian?
Actually, I'm a shrink. I do outpatient mental health services here. Oh, I went to medical school. I was going to be a veterinarian. I actually love animals.
Why didn't you?
I couldn't stand the idea of dealing with neurotic pet owners on a daily basis. Oh, sorry.
It's okay. It is sad how people attribute human qualities to animals instead of just eating their flesh or wearing their fur.
So, Adam, let's talk about you now.
Me?
Mm-hmm. You want to tell me what drove you to stab your dog?
Oh. It was an accident. Look, I love this dog more than I love myself. I know it sounds dumb, but I'm not crazy.
I know you're not crazy. You know, actually, it's refreshing to meet somebody who loves someone or something that much.
Oh.
Hey, greetings, gay doctor roommate. Tough day at the orifice?
You know, a woman who thinks God speaks through her vagina.
Oh, wait, Polly?
Oh, no, Michael. No, please.
Like blonde, 30s, 5'8"?
Michael, you had sex with a homeless woman?
It was kind of sweet, actually. It's not the way you make it sound. It was actually, we actually cuddled a lot. It was very intimate.
Yeah, well, she was probably cold.
You know, homeless people have needs. You know, they need love like other folks. You know, I helped her. I provided a service for her, actually. You know, for 5 minutes, her vagina stopped talking to her.
Michael, I'm gonna take a shower for both of us.
Your mother be happy marrying a doctor. Is he Jewish?
I don't think so. Whatever, I'll never see him again unless I go insane.
Adam, we're like in our 30s. We're almost 40. You need to be more aggressive. Why don't you go back to the hospital?
No.
Why not?
He already thinks I'm a crazy pet person.
You're the only person I know that showers before the gym.
Well, I need to blow off some steam.
Among other things.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
God. You gay guys are so lucky. You get to connect and make love to someone different every night.
Yeah.
If women were as promiscuous as you, there'd be like orgies in the street.
Yeah, well, thanks to you, there already are.
Oh, no. I brought her back here. Well, have fun having gay, anonymous sex in the low self-esteem room.
Thanks.
Hey, you're hot. I wish I had your body, but like with my face.
I wish you did too.
God, don't you just love this gym? It feels so good to sweat out the Tina, you know what I mean?
Actually, I don't. I don't use drugs, and neither should you.
Ew! It sounds like somebody had a bad experience with drugs.
Excuse me?
No, it's okay. I'm just really observant. I notice things that other guys might not.
Is that so?
Yeah. I'm gonna be an actor, so I pick up on people's personalities. You don't do drugs, because you have what they call control issues. You're like totally afraid to be out of control of your body or let someone see you in a less than perfect light. You're really afraid of letting your hair down. Unless it has to do with sex. And then you can completely cut loose and...
Hey!
Sorry.
Ew! Dogs are so gross. How can someone love something that shits right in front of them?
Could you eat any of these birds if you had to? You know, like if terrorists poison the food supply.
Oh, look, everyone. We have a duck in flight directly above us.
I'm so sorry, and this usually doesn't happen.
Hey, you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just bruised a rib.
Oh my God, it is you. It's you, the dog guy.
Hi.
Hey.
Wow. What a coincidence.
Yeah,
huh?
Right? How is your dog, speaking of bruised ribs?
He's all better. He pees on the floor sometimes. Or is that me?
Wait, you do like a bird watching tours around here?
Yeah. You thought you were the only one to deal with crazies.
That was actually pretty heroic of you, you know? Tackling that guy, getting all dirty.
Oh, well, it was heroic of you to save my dog, and I don't mind getting dirty.
Oh, I know, yeah.
You know, I'm really sorry I was such a mess at the hospital.
Wait a minute. Just, here, let me do something. Wait a minute. Come here. It's all right. It's just, here. Here, look at me. There, that's better.
So listen, I'm gonna be an aggressive type person here. And take you out to dinner sometime.
Oh, you know, you don't have to do that.
No, I want to.
Really, it's fine.
No, I want to.
Really, it's okay.
Really, I want to.
No, it's really, it's fine.
But I want to.
It's all right.
I kind of like to.
Oh, I don't know. It's fine.
No, but I'd like to.
You should. I know. Let me ask you out to dinner.
No, that's okay.
No, I'm serious. I want to.
No, you don't have to.
But I want to.
Well, I'm flattered, but...
Well, no, really, come on, I want to.
Listen, I should take you out to dinner to thank you for what you did for Bert.
Well, it's just about your dog. I mean, you know, it's really not necessary. If you're asking me, like, on a date, like a romantic type thing, you know, then I would maybe have to say yes to such an aggressive type person.
Well, it just so happens to be a romantic date type thing, so yeah, that's right.
Okay, yeah, good. Wow, how about tomorrow night?
Tomorrow night's great, where?
How about right here in the park, you know, the bathhouse?
The boathouse?
I know, Sona. Sona on 6th at 6.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah?
Great.
Good.
All right. Okay, well, I'll see you there.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Are you sure you want to do this?
You chill out. You sound like a jealous wife.
Well, you know, you're going to have to change your whole lifestyle, you know. He's got a dog. You're going to have to hide all the knives.
Michael, it's just a date, okay? Look, I'm 36 years old. Maybe I'm tired of one hot sexual encounter after another. I mean, maybe I want to find out what it's like to have okay sex with the same person on a regular basis.
I'm very disappointed in you, Steve. Obviously, you're not the person that I thought you were.
Michael, I can still see you.
Okay, one apple martini, a Diet Coke.
You don't drink?
No, I'm on antibiotics.
Anything, communicable?
Oh, no. No, nothing communicable. No, it's been a while since I've communicated with anyone.
You mean since you've had sex? How long?
Oh, you know, I don't know. Not that long. Like 6 months.
Wow.
Although I did meet this one guy on the phone sex line who came over, but he lied about what he looked like, you know. When he showed up, he was like 20 years older and 50 pounds heavier than he said. And short. Well, he was a dwarf. Or a midget, I get them confused. Yeah, he had crossed eyes and burns on his face. No ears. I think he might have been born with a hare lip, but that could have been from the fire, you know. Yeah. I don't think he should have lied about those things, you know?
No.
I told him that, too, like, right after we had sex. Thank you.
You know, I have to tell you, I don't go on dates very often, but you know, ever since I saw you at the ER, you seem familiar somehow.
Hmm. Did you grow up on Long Island?
Uh-uh. Texas.
You don't have an accent.
Where'd you go to college?
I went to NYU briefly, but it didn't work out.
I don't know. I guess it's just, one of those things, huh?
Oh, well, I was in a porn movie once. Maybe you saw it.
Really?
No.
Okay. Really?
No. No, no. No.
So, you're an ornithologist?
No. I just watch birds for a living. Yeah, business can be kind of slow in the winter, but it's a steady paycheck and trying to keep it simple right now.
Keep it simple?
Yeah, listen. I don't have an infection. I'm in recovery. And part of that is being honest about that.
Good for you, Adam. Good for you. Listen, I deal with a lot of people who have addictive personalities.
Hey, wake up. It's not over to the Fat Lady Sings, and I ain't sung yet. Boy, tough crowd. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, if you throw any wilted vegetables, I will simply eat them. Although pork ribs are my favorite, feel free to throw those. Isn't it funny how the more ribs you eat, the less you can see of your own?
You know, I know her, I think.
Are those chocolate-covered crickets I hear in the audience?
Yeah,
she was funny.
Well, you're sweet to say that, but really, she wasn't.
Aw, thanks for coming.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, what a shitty audience, right?
This is Steve.
Hey.
Oh, the doctor with the heart of gold. Nice to meet you.
I know you, right? Don't I?
Well, I was just on stage.
Wait a minute. Oh, my God. Marie's Crisis. You're the cocktail waitress
in my
apartment.
Oh, yeah, I work there on weekends. This place doesn't really pay, so.
Yeah, I guess you don't, recognize
me. No, I'm too self-absorbed to notice other people.
I'm sorry, did you say something?
Ha, 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 ha,
Guys, excuse me. I'm going to take care of some business.
Okay.
I know,
I know. He's so cute. And we've been having, like, the best time. Like, the more I talk to him, the more it's like I've known him my whole life.
Past lives.
Yeah.
You're about as funny as a heart attack.
Oh, thanks, Dad.
Oh. Okay, well, here I am. Oh.
What?
Well, aren't you worried about getting gay bashed or yelled at?
No. No, my God, nothing like that's ever happened to me.
Yeah, just that every time I've expressed affection in public, some asshole from Jersey throws a beer bottle at me.
Wow. Sounds like you've had really bad luck.
Oh, Bert! Oh, Bert! Bert, look at you! Give me five. Hey! Look at you, you're all better now.
Did you come?
No, I think your dog is licking my foot.
Oh. Bert, go to your bed! Go! I'm sorry. I don't think he understands what's happening to his daddy.
Do you understand what's happening to his daddy?
No. Yes. Yeah.
Come here.
Bells will ring and angels sing. There's something in the air. Cupid brings the star of spring with something to declare. And now it's love, love. Aphrodite bitten, Juliet was reeling. Now I know the feeling. My heart's been palpitating, hyperventilating from the kissing and the smacking. Aphrodisiac, and I'm in love, love, love. What a gas to be in love, 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 love. Love, love, love. Like it has to be in love, love. Who'd have thought that you and me be talking L-O-V-E? You can guarantee that we both agree. I know it seems askew and relatively new to me. You'll say I do because we're both in love, love, love. What a gas to be in love, 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 love. Love, love, love. Like it has to be in love, love. Two ships in the night become a cruise ship of delight on an ocean of an arm iniquity. The owl's on the prowl and the pussycat is scowl. She winked her eyes, said, come sail with me.
At one point.
Really?
Uh-huh. I was a theater major. Couldn't deal with bohemia. Such a messy lifestyle. Very, very messy. What are you doing? What are you doing?
When was your last relationship?
by relationship, what exactly do you mean?
Your last boyfriend? Lover? Homosexual lifetime commitment partner companion?
I don't know, I've never really had a long-term one. Nobody's really held my interest for that long, you know?
Great.
No, wait a minute. Wait now. You know, when I was a kid, I figured I'd grow up, meet a nice guy, have a big wedding. But it all had to be a certain way, you know? Like in the movies I'd see.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, I'd always watch those movies and I'd superimpose myself over the man and then the woman, you know, like a back and forth. Like in one scene, I'd be Julia Roberts, and then in the next scene, I'd be, you know, like Julia Roberts.
Really? I'm Meg Ryan.
Hi, Meg. Yeah, you're blonde.
Oh, Julia, come on. Hey, you ever gone gay two-stepping over at the Big Apple Rodeo in Midtown?
Two-stepping? No, I can barely one-step. What do you wear to something like that? Oh my God, it's a hoedown. Come here.
I don't know how to do this.
No, relax, okay? It's really easy. All we do is look at this. You go quick, quick, step. Exactly. It's just a repetition of the same move, except we're going to be going that way, all right?
Okay.
Ready? Here we go.
Okay.
In. Quick, quick, step. Good.
Quick, quick.
Exactly.
Ow! I'm sorry.
It's okay. Let's keep going, all right?
Okay. I'm sorry.
It's all right. Look, you'll get the hang of it, all right? Come on, let's just keep going, all right?
Okay.
Here we go. And. Quick step.
Good. That's good.
Hey, Steve.
Hey, Andy. This is, Adam.
Looks like someone's having a little bit of trouble here.
Yeah, well, I'm Jewish. You know, give me a bottle dance and I'm fine.
Well, I teach private lessons. So if you ever want to take this seriously at all, you just let me know.
Actually, Andy's a really great instructor.
Not that you ever needed any instructing. Your dancing's not bad either. Shalom, cowboy.
God, I'm terrible at this.
Oh, no, you just started now. Come on, try and relax, all right? Here we go.
Ah, now this is much better.
This is just like any slow song.
That's right, except in heels.
I tried to be a good dancer once.
What happened?
Have you ever been to a sober dance? I hate to point this out, but dancing is 90% beer.
What about dirty dancing?
Wow, you're in a mood. You're like a different person tonight.
Well, I'm happy. I'm dating someone.
That guy Andy is really hot.
I guess. But, he's not my boyfriend. You are.
Never did I know I'd feel the way I do. You changed my life in so many ways. And the moment that we kissed, showed me what.
Are you sure he said boyfriend? He didn't say, boy, do I need a friend.
Yeah, I didn't know what to say to him. You know, I look at him sometimes and I have these feelings like I cherish him. But then I always feel like I'm waiting for the other shoe to drop, like it always has.
He seems to be moving awfully fast for a psychiatrist. I mean, the whole idea of this romantic myth stuff is a recipe for disaster. He's a shrink, he should know this.
Yeah, he is a shrink. I think he knows more about this stuff than us. He has a degree. We just have Oprah.
Now, Oprah has made it impossible for me to have a close relationship with anyone besides Oprah.
But he's so normal, and I'm such a freak. We're really different.
I think that's good. But the thing about you gay guys is that you're just obsessed with finding carbon copies of yourself, at least with guys and girls. We know we'll never figure each other out, so we just say, like, oh, he's just being a man, or, oh, she's just on the rag.
I guess.
Have you had a fight yet?
No. Is that weird?
Well, you do have some things in common. You two steps and you 12 step.
You know, maybe your comedy is like my love life. You know, if you stop trying so hard, it'll come, you know?
But fat jokes are my forte. And being fat was the only funny thing that ever happened to me. It's the only thing some idiot off the street would find interesting about me.
Who are these for?
My friends Jeff and Jeff are bringing their new foster child.
Ah, kids. I think I saw some of those on TV once.
You ever think about having kids?
No, I already have one myself.
I love children. Can't imagine anybody not loving kids. Would you stop it? Come here.
Hello!
Hi. Hi, Michael.
So Steve tells me you used to be fat?
Oh, Adam told me you used to be short.
Were you, like, fat or circus fat?
You know, you really ought to be standing when you insult a lady. Oh, wait, you already are.
What'd you do with all that loose skin? Did you, like, donate it to a burn unit or something?
No, I gave it to the little people. The real little people, not the fake little people like you.
Wow. Cute kid, huh? Wonder if she's gay. Look, I just wanted to let you know that I think it's cool that you and Steve are hanging out and, you know, doing your gay love thing.
Aw. Thanks, Michael. That's sweet.
Yeah.
Yes, I know.
I just, you know, before he met you, he was such a whore.
No, sorry. Whores get paid. He was a slut.
He used to go to, like, the gym every night and just go in the shower and hook up with, like, hundreds of guys. Like, the hottest guys in New York for the taking. You know, to be honest with you, I could never really understand why he would, like, give up all that easy lovemaking. But, you know, I understand that you guys want equal rights, so. Your best friend's cute. She's kind of a bitch, though, right?
Yeah.
What time do your folks get in?
They should be here in about an hour.
Did you put away Michael's porn?
Yep.
Did you put away Michael?
Yeah. He's at a Three Stooges convention at the Javits Center.
Oh, I hope they like me.
Honey, you'll be fine. They're the ones who should be worried about what you think. They're entering our world.
No, when you're a born-again Christian, your world follows you.
But they're not that religious anymore. Look, I've been out for 10 years. They've had plenty of time to get used to the idea that eventually I'd meet somebody. Huh?
Ew! Facts! Welcome to the West Village, asshole. Better get used to it.
Oh, for a second. Okay.
You know, Jesus was a Jew.
That's right. He sure was.
Would anybody care for some wine?
Oh, that would be delightful.
Open that box of Zinfandel we brought. Show them what we bought at the airport.
It's not for dinner. It's just for decoration. It was made from actual ceramic chips recovered from the
Here we go.
Here we are.
Don't you want some?
Oh, no, I'm an alcoholic. He's in recovery. Excuse us for a minute, Mom, Dad. I feel like I have a sign around my neck that reads, I eat your son's ass. Stop it. Just act like you know what you're doing, okay? We have to show them there's nothing wrong with being gay. Look, they're in New York now, not Texas.
Good Lordy, these windows are so big. I feel like I could just fall right out.
Not exactly a ton of privacy, though, is there?
Mom, Dad, I just wanted to say that normally Adam and I are very affectionate with each other, and we don't feel that it would be fair to us, or really to you, if we behaved in a way that somehow demonstrated that we are in any way ashamed of our feelings for each other. I think it's important that we express our normal, healthy affection for each other in your presence. Right? And, well, I just wanted to say that.
Oh, well, don't not be y'all's usual selves. It's just because we're here.
Yes. We're all grown-ups here.
Ew! Facts!
So how would a person find curtains for a window so big, son?
New York is a very big city, so,
Corn Holler!
How's that wine? Any left?
We don't have any more boxes of wine. I can open an actual bottle.
Cocksuckers!
Cockscrew's right there on the counter. Cork!
Got it. Right here. Never having sex again.
No, they'll be fine. No, they really liked you.
As your dad was leaving, he told me I was going to hell.
Yeah, well, he only tries to save the people he likes. How come you never talk about your family? Where are they, in the witness protection program or something?
My family is really weird. They're not lucky.
Adam, there's no such thing as luck, okay?
Yeah, there is. Listen, if you want to meet them, you can come with me to Hanukkah dinner in a few months. If you still like me.
If I still like you?
Yeah, I know. I'm just making an assumption there.
Come on. I more than like you.
Adam, I love you.
You just had to say it first, didn't you?
I'm sorry. It's easier for me to say it than to hear it.
Adam, I love you. I love you. I love you.
Yeah.
Adam, I do. I love you.
Steve, I am ridiculously in love and therefore extremely unreachable, but leave a message and I'll get back to you.
This next comic used to be really fat, which means that now a pussy's probably really tight because no one's ever been in there. She's the hottest female comic this side of, I can't think of any hot female comics. But even if you don't think she's funny, and she's not, then just turn her around and look upon Rhonda Gurnon and her amazing heart-shaped ass.
Thank you. Wow. You know, Lou, I always knew you were crazy, but in those pants, I can see your nuts. And they're sad. They're sad because there's no one up there. No pork, just beans. No sausage for your country breakfast. No condiments for your meat. No relish. No sauce. Lou's so small. Ask me how small he is.
How small is he?
Lou's so small, his last girlfriend was a pencil sharpener. Lou's so small, he doesn't get crabs, he dates them. Lou's so small, if he were a drink, he'd be a no pina colada. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Oh, I don't see anything. I guess it's Lou's penis. Well, obviously, there's one man in the audience who's secure enough with his masculinity to laugh at my jokes. Hey, thanks for coming.
Oh, yeah.
I'm laughing.
Yeah. Hi. You're funny.
I just got fired.
All Lou did was compliment you on your ass. Why'd you make fun of him?
Because in this heart-shaped ass is an asshole, which is, I guess, what I am. It's gross. It's good to see you. Have fun with Gloria Steinem here.
You know, I'm not with her. She just sat next to me.
I'm not your mother.
Oh, well, you kind of look like her.
That's good. I'm late. I gotta go stare into a black hole, so.
You know, I don't see Steve as often as I used to ever since he hooked up with Adam. I think they're completely wrong for each other, don't you agree?
Oh, come on, they're fags. You know how it is. Besides, I think it's good. Adam's luck has completely changed since they met. Why am I talking to you?
Hey, you want to get a drink or something? It's so early. You want to get a hot toddy?
I try not to drink.
Don't get thirsty?
You know, your body's 90% water.
Booze, it's the carbs.
Oh, right. Are there carbohydrates in pot?
Oh. Wow, public access. Can you believe they get away with that? Oh, hey, look. American Movie Classics. You like that, don't you?
Isn't it funny how the only requirement for a movie to be a classic is that it be over 40 years old?
I never thought of that.
You're funny.
Funny lady.
Oh my God, I love that movie.
Oh my God, me too. Steve makes me watch it all the time.
Except I think Funny Girl is much more satisfying.
Well, I think that's the common opinion.
That's common opinion. I've got the munchies.
My God, what are you doing? I can't eat that.
Oh, you can't have one pie?
No, I can't have one pie. One pie is like an appetizer to me. I eat that, I unleash the beast.
Well, then come on, Rhonda. Unleash the beast.
I had a slip.
Thanks, gents. Have a good night.
Thank you. Okay. All right, okay.
I don't think this is such a good idea.
What is the big deal? Look, you met my parents. I want to meet yours.
All I'm saying is that they're...
I know, they're not lucky.
They're kind of cursed.
Well, if they're anything as dramatic as their son, Adam, focus, okay? Relax. You always exaggerate everything. Go. Go in. Okay? Go. It's okay.
Hello? We're here.
Darn it, we just replaced that thing last week.
Happy Hanukkah.
You must be Steve.
Hi.
Welcome, 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 welcome.
I'm Adam's father. I'm Norm, and this is Sherry, and this is our beautiful daughter Ruth.
Hi, it's so nice to meet you. Oh.
Ooh, did you bite your tongue again, sweetie?
Hi. Hi, Ruth. Mrs. Bernstein. Thank you for having me.
Please call me Sherry. Any boyfriend of Adam's is a boyfriend of mine.
And that's right. It's getting a little rare having this and come around and visit us once in a while. I think he's just a little embarrassed about the Bernstein curse.
Dad, there is no such thing.
Are you enjoying?
Steve, matzah?
Oh, yes, thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Seven more.
I thought that was shatterproof.
All right. I'm sorry, I just have to ask this, but are all of you okay with this?
You know, I used to charge people a quarter every time they ask us that question, but nobody could afford it. Lowered it to a nickel, and it still broke practically everybody's bank. Happiness is accepting life on life's terms. You know, I mean, no matter what they happen to be, you just do your best with what you've been given.
Till we found out we were luck challenged, we thought there was a poltergeist or something. We were on In Search Of in the 70s, you know, with Spock.
Oh, we still have the tape. We'll show it to you after we light the menorah.
Mom, can we get through a Hanukkah without watching that tape?
Adam just hates that tape. He was a real pizza face back then, you know.
Too busy with all that white face paint to clear. Anybody want coffee?
White face paint? I was a goth in high school.
Who would like coffee?
Oh, we're out of coffee.
It's okay. Look, it's kind of late for coffee anyway.
You know what? Let's spin the dreidel and open presents.
Yay!
Well, now that you have a special friend, I want to see more of you around here.
Dad, Steve is Adam's lover. God, you're so square.
Oh, it was such a pleasure to meet you, Steve, and I, thank you. So happy that my Adam has found someone as nice as you.
Oh, Sherry, look, thanks for making me feel so welcome, and for such an amazing meal.
Yeah, it was made with love.
You know, I hate to see you waste money taking a taxi to the train station. Don't you want us to give you a ride?
No. Thank you, no.
A lesbian diet and put on makeup at the same time?
I don't know why.
Because you can't eat Jenny Craig with Mary Kay on your face. Does anyone know what mothballs smell like?
Yes.
Oh, really? How'd you get them to spread their little legs? Have an audition for a lesbian cruise ship next week. Very excited about it. I like lesbians. Lesbians like me. Trying to cut down on the fat jokes, though.
I still can't even imagine you fat.
Oh, I can. Oh, honey, show Steve that photo.
No.
Oh, come on.
Here we go.
No. I look like a Long Island blimp with a bad Chinese lady prom. No.
You know, speaking of Long Island, you know, we went to Long Island last week. Went to Adam's parents' house.
Oh my God, I was there once, and a piece of space lab splashed down into their pool.
Actually, I'm gonna ask Adam to marry me.
Oh my God!
Marry him? But you guys have only been going out for like a couple months.
Actually, it's almost been a year, Michael. Besides, my parents got married on the third date, and they're still together.
Well, you're only as monogamous as your options. I mean, your parents live in a trailer park in a field.
Excuse me, only as monogamous as their options?
You know, it gets worse, Michael. I'm gonna ask him to move in.
Oh my God! Oh, I knew this day was gonna come!
You know what? You said you needed a place to crash for the night. You've been living on my couch for 5 years.
Jesus, Michael, be happy for them.
Please.
Well, I think it's great. He's gonna flip out. He really loves you.
I love him too. I do. You know, it's funny. When I was a kid, I just supposed I'd get married like everybody else, but, I don't know. Turned out I was gay, and I just figured it wasn't in the cards, but... I mean, I don't even know what I think of marriage anyway. Sometimes I think it's a dying institution.
Yeah, well, it is. Then you fall in love.
Exactly. Sometimes I look at him and I think, this is not the person I was supposed to end up with, but, I don't know. Somehow it's all okay.
So who gets to wear the dress?
You do.
Hey, good looking.
Hey. Wait a minute. Come here.
want to take you someplace, okay?
Oh, God. Please don't tell me there's something called three-stepping.
No. No, it's just my favorite place in the city. You game?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Okay.
Brooklyn Bridge, that's your favorite place?
Uh-huh. Let's go.
Come on, come on.
God, I haven't been here in years. It's getting harder to remember where the towers were, you know?
You were in New York on that day. What was it like?
Oh, I don't know. It was just crazy.
These are crazy times. Makes things like, I don't know, security, commitment more important.
I can't believe that you brought me here. My drug problem began on this very spot. Well, no, actually it began at Danceteria, this club in the 80s. This go-go boy cokehead with big ol' like Dee Snider hair. He was part of some dance troupe. What was it called? The Dazzle Dancers. Well, he fed me my first hit of blow, and we went back to my place, and he shit right in front of me, all over my carpet. My place looked like something out of Willy Wonka after he left. Oh, and he was singing some song from the... What was it from? Like, The Sound of Music. Oh my God, how could I have forgotten that?
Oh my God.
Oh my Jesus, oh my God.
Honey?
Oh my God! I have to get out of here. All I can see is disaster. No, disaster, Mama! I need time to think, Adam. Time to think. Think.
Where are you going?
So we just ran away yelling disaster?
Yeah, we were talking about the World Trade Centers and what happened, and he just freaked out.
Runner's lunge?
Well, he is a doctor in New York City.
He was in Provincetown on 9/11.
Back into down dog.
Well, I call you when he's ready. Everybody gets the jitters before.
Sweep forward into up dog.
Before what?
Attack.
Internal focus,
Why?
Just that he wasn't ready, and he said I didn't really know who he was.
Oh my God, why is this happening?
It's the Bernstein curse.
You know, you date. You look for the person who has the least amount of flaws, and then you find someone who you think is about as perfect as you can get.
Well, but, of course, there's no such thing as perfection.
Why do people project this image of themselves as, like, completely opposite from who they are?
Maybe they're just afraid that they won't be loved for who they really are.
But that's crazy. I mean, you come home one day and you think you know this person, then all of a sudden you realize you do not know this person from Adam.
You just get to Stephen Hicks.
Are you one of his patients?
Don't make me go Shirley MacLaine on you. You better give that guy some closure, or he's gonna wind up in here in a body cast.
Look, I appreciate you standing up for your friend, but I did give Adam closure, all right?
In a shower stall.
Look,
All right, okay, I admit perhaps it was a little abrupt, but what in
one
the
one minute you're telling me you want to marry him on that bullshit about commitment, and you're a total slut.
Look, you don't understand the situation, okay? There are things about me you just don't know, all right?
Like what?
Like, we just aren't right for each other. He doesn't really love me. We were codependent, and then...
But there are good things about being Cody. It's called depending on another person. You act like you're so grown up, like you're so above it. But you're an asshole and a baby. You're an asshole who's also a baby.
I'm getting marriage advice from some gay whore. Great.
All right, let me get this straight. You meet Adam in 1987. You turn him into a cokehead, and then you poop on him. All in the same night?
It wasn't my fault. It was cut with baby laxative.
Yeah, I've had some bad dates, but nothing like, you know, a biohazard.
How could we have dated for so long and never recognized each other?
Oh, it was the 80s. It was a long time ago. You know, you're like Simon Le Bon in a boat looking through the jungle for the cat lady. And, you know, he was like the guy with the fiddle and the suspenders singing, "Come on, Eileen."
Or you could tell him.
No.
Who you were.
No, Michael.
Cause you
no, know he me. Can't find.
No, be.
Michael, don't you dare say a word to him or Rhonda. Michael, do you hear me?
I told you, I don't know. I just know that he said Adam isn't the one.
Michael. Michael. Michael, is that the whole story?
Well, there is the other thing.
What? What other thing, Michael?
About Adam and Steve. It's kind of gross. I think I should tell you after dinner.
Why? What do you know, Michael?
And then he broke up with me. Shower.
Steve is a go-go dancer.
Excuse me, this is a private meeting.
Silence, sober one!
What go-go dancer?
From Danceteria! That Hershey squirtin' cokehead!
Excuse me, you are challenging our serenity.
Shut up!
Wait, from the 80s? Willy Wonka? Oh my God. Oh my God!
Oh, Adam! Steve loves you! He just can't get past this humiliation over the diarrhea thing and for turning you into some gay John Belushi! That's why he broke up with you!
But that is crazy! God, you're right, he is totally unaware for a shrink.
I'm telling you, they're like preacher's kids!
Cross-talking is not allowed!
Mary, please!
He's so confused!
No, he's just an asshole. And a baby. He's a baby who's also an asshole!
Where are you going?
What just happened?
And the moment that we kissed, you showed me what love.
If you imagine it, you can achieve it. If you dream it, you can become.
They say the good ones are always taken, but I. And how, oh, how did I find you?
Are you walking down the street happy as a pig in mud, feeling simple and
love songs about diarrhea. You got a foot in tomorrow and a foot in yesterday.
Not bad for a dazzle dancer.
You'll get nothing but sorrow because you're crapping on today. No matter what, you've got to keep on laughing. Just laugh with your mouth shut. This shit happens.
Monster and unleashed him onto the gay community to wreak havoc on midgets. Adam, look! I gave you your first bump of coke. I became incontinent in front of you.
Became incontinent? God, you were such an old lady. You're just embarrassed.
Yes. All right, yes, I am. I'd be happy to course through life having a lover who thought I never went to the bathroom at all. Who thought that some little dove just came and swept it all away when I wasn't looking. Wait,
what? What do you want?
I don't know, okay? I don't want some open relationship like all the gay couples I know. I don't want some gay version of the straight couples I see. I don't see what I want anywhere.
Then just see me. You know, we're just us. We're not gay or straight or Julia or Meg. We're just two people. Adam and Steve. Maybe we should just accept the fact that neither of those people are relationship material. That they're both too damaged. We're in our 30s. Of course we're damaged. And you know what? I am tired. I am tired of fighting you and the whole world just so I can have something as radical and subversive as a fucking boyfriend. Fuck you, Steve. I may be damaged goods, but I am goods nonetheless.
It's not my fault! You wouldn't understand. She's a woman. They have their ways.
Well, she hypnotized you with her feminine wiles?
Yes! Yes! Yes, she did! She did, actually! What? What was I supposed to do, Michael? Every time he went to an AA meeting, I'd feel guilty. Every time I used the bathroom, he'd stare at me with a knowing look on his face.
Get over yourself. The guy saw you take a dump. You'd eventually start changing each other's diapers anyway.
No. No, this is not how it's supposed to be.
You've got to stop with that preconceived bullshit. You guys love each other, don't you?
I don't even know what that means anymore.
God made Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve.
Where you go?
There you go, guys. I gotta go get limes, honey. I'll be right back.
To say hi. You don't get much of nothing unless you give it a try. Rock the world a little, get the thunder clapping. Arch yourself right over there and make things happen. Give yourself a gift you can use. What the hell have you got to lose? We're really all just walking in each other's shoes. Step one. Look. Two.
This is Charlie. He lives across the street from me.
Hi.
Hi.
Go ahead. Ask him.
Ask him.
What's your name?
Adam.
And what's mine?
Steve.
That's right, Steve. Adam and Steve. So you see, you were wrong. God did make Adam and Steve because here we are. All right, tell him.
Huh? Tell him.
Steve is sorry for the way he treated you. He's sorry about everything.
Well, I accept his apology.
And?
I'm sorry I yelled at you, called you cornholers in front of his parents.
Okay.
And what else?
What else?
He wants to ask you for your hand in one of them gay marriages.
A man marry a man? That's kind of gross.
I know.
Well, you tell him that personally, I don't really believe in marriage. And I don't really know if I believe in him anymore.
Whoa. It's harsh.
Adam. Please.
Can't.
Adam, I choose you. I choose you.
I don't know why you would.
Perhaps I had a wicked childhood. Perhaps I had a miserable youth. But somewhere in my wicked, miserable past, there must have been a moment of truth. For here you are, standing there, loving me. So somewhere in my youth or childhood, I must have done something good. Nothing comes from so somewhere in my youth or childhood, I must have done something good.
Thank you.
Beloved family and friends, at this time in the wedding, we do the ring ceremony. Rhonda, if you would give me Adam's ring for Steve. Thank you. Michael, if you would give me Steve's ring for Adam. Thank you. We hold hands. Father, Mother, God, we ask just now for your blessing on these beautiful wedding rings, that they may symbolize for Adam and Steve in their union health and happiness, strength and courage, joy and peace, abundance and prosperity, and unconditional loving for each other. So be it. Adam, if you would place this ring on Stephen's hand and repeat after me, Steve, with this ring, I thee wed.
Steve, with this ring, I thee wed.
Steve, if you would place this ring on Adam's hand and repeat after me, Adam, with this ring, I thee wed.
Adam, with this ring, I thee wed.
Do you, Adam Bernstein, take Steve Hicks to be your beloved husband?
I do.
Steve Hicks, do you take Adam Bernstein to be your beloved husband?
You bet your ass I do.
And now, by the power vested in me by the state of New York, I now pronounce you husband and husband. You may kiss your beloved. And now, Adam, in the tradition of your family, we'll break the glass.
Don't write love songs about diarrhea. sorrow, cause you're crappy enough today. No matter what, you got to keep on laughing. Just laugh with your mouth shut, cause shit happens.
They don't write love songs about diarrhea.